So this is a phenomenon called a water wilt. This is a picture of some tomatoes that are experiencing it. And so when the soil is waterlogged, like it is in my area, I had three questions yesterday. The airspace in the soil fills up with water and restricts oxygen uptake to the plant. The roots also are injured and the plant cannot take up enough water. So the plant looks like it does in a drought condition. And in essence, it is being deprived of water. And so it looks like it's being deprived of water. I've got another picture of cabbage. Again, the plants may come out of it depending on the plant and also how long the saturation lasts. And there isn't anything to do about it. I did have someone ask me about spraying a fungicide. No, you wouldn't do that. And someone else asked me about adding cat litter to absorb the water. And no, I would not recommend that. Just wait it out. And hopefully the plants are going to come out of it once the rains stop and we get some sunshine and dries up. So one thing you could do is work on improving drainage for next year. So you could add organic matter. You could consider raised beds for really low spots or really poorly drained soils. Container gardening would also be an option. I wanted to show too that trees also have problems when they receive too much water. And the area I'm in the Northwest region, we will have trees underwater for extended periods of time, just from the amount of rain we've had and how low some of this area is. And the same thing, the roots are being deprived of oxygen. And when the temperatures are high, the tree can die in standing water. And it may not die this year, but it does have adverse effects on the tree. And like I said, sometimes for years to come.